One of the most stunning and dangerous volcanoes in Chile can be found a mere 30 kilometers northeast of the major city of Puerto Montt, population 250,000. Rising to a height of 1,974 meters or 6,476 feet is the glacier-capped edifice of the Calbuco Volcano. While most famous for producing large sub-plinian and plinian eruptions in both 1893 and 2015, multiple prior eruptions in prehistoric times were an order of magnitude more explosive. Part of the reason why Calbuco Volcano is not a perfect, uninterrupted cone like the Eruption volcano to the north is that it produced a catastrophic collapse which vastly changed its edifice approximately 14,000 years ago. This debris avalanche was slightly larger in volume than witnessed as a result of the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, involving 3 cubic kilometers of material which collapsed to the north and northwest, leaving behind numerous raised hills in the landscape that are today classified as hummocky terrain. There are also 2 large debris fans representing both alluvial fans and lahar deposits that formed as a result of repeated large-scale explosive eruptions. The fact that more than 5,000 people live on these deposits, which are at high risk of being inundated by additional lahars during future eruptions, are part of the reason why Calbuco is rated as the third most potentially dangerous volcano in all of Chile. In fact, here are the other volcanoes listed in the top 10 within Chile. So, why does the Calbuco volcano exist? And is it part of the Andes mountain range? While not as high elevation as those in the Altiplano Plateau, Calbuco is indeed part of this 8,900-kilometer-long mountain range. It exists like the vast majority of Andes volcanoes due to the offshore collision of 2 tectonic plates in the Pacific Ocean. There, the Nazca Plate is subducting underneath the South American Plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards, occasionally forming intrusions which reach the surface and erupt, producing a chain of volcanoes. While a preceding volcanic system did exist at approximately the same location as the current Calbuco volcano going as far back as 200,000 years ago, it is safe to say that the modern volcano did not truly begin to form until 100,000 years ago. This marks when intermittent and scattered basaltic andesite volcanism evolved to more viscous primarily and acidic volcanism which originated from a central vent. Eruptions which occurred were almost universally quite explosive, involving strong volcanian eruptions which produced ash and pyroclastic flows, along with less frequent but even stronger sub-plinian and plinian eruptions. Erupting at a rate of 2 to 4 cubic kilometers of material per 1,000 years, overlapping layers of lava and ash constructed a towering gray-colored central edifice. Eventually, this edifice became tall enough that a glacier began growing on its summit and flanks. These glaciers carved away valleys as they advanced at least 7 kilometers away from Calbuco's summit in some sectors. Between 30,000 and 7,000 years ago, larger volumes of less viscous basaltic andesite lava erupted in relation to andesite than in the prior period. It was during this period that the volcano partially collapsed to the north and northwest, but its high eruptive volume quickly hid the scar which formed. Major explosive eruptions followed around 10,000 and 7,000 years ago, the latter of which generated 20-kilometer-long pyroclastic flows to the west of the volcano. In the last 1,000 years, Calbuco has produced at least 15 distinct eruptions, 2 of which rated as a 4 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index. Specifically, in 1893 to 1894 and 2015. The lava flows seen on its east and northeast flanks were replaced by smaller eruptions in 1917, 1929, and 1961. Calbuco's major eruptions seem to be followed in the following 2 decades by an increased rate of less intense eruptions, so we might expect some small VEI 1, 2, and possibly 3 eruptions to occur at Calbuco before the year 2035. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.